The people of Lut denied the warnings. We unleashed a sudden squall of stones against all of them. The land of Anatolia. The plains of Mesopotamia. The Arabian Peninsula. And the continent of Africa have witnessed the births of different civilizations since the beginning of time. God sent messengers to them throughout history and called them to his path. Those people who refused to believe the messengers sent to them, who tried to kill or exile them, were all destroyed. One of these civilizations was found within the borders of the present-day state of Israel. This people who settled by the shores of the Dead Sea were the people of Lut. According to the Quran, homosexuality was so rife among these people to whom the prophet Lut had been sent that its like had never been seen before. When their brother Lut said to them, "Will you not do your duty? I am a faithful messenger to you, so heed God and obey me. I do not ask you for any wage for it. My wage is the responsibility of no one but the Lord of all the worlds. Of all beings, do you lie with males, leaving the wives God has created for you? You are a people who have overstepped the limits." When Lut told them to renounce their perversions and brought them God's commands, they denied him, rejected that he was a prophet, and continued with their perverted ways. In return for that behavior, they were destroyed in a terrible catastrophe. Let us now have a look at the archaeological evidence that has recently been unearthed regarding this people that are discussed in the Quran. When we look at the Old Testament, the holy book of both Christians and Jews, we see that the matter is described in the same terms as in the Quran. According to the Old Testament, the city where this deviant people lived was Sodom. Archaeological discoveries from excavations reveal that the city was built near the Dead Sea, which runs along the Israel-Jordanian border. Archaeologists working in the area unearthed evidence of a terrible disaster here. The terrible damage to the human skeletons unearthed bore the signs of a powerful earthquake. According to the Quran, angels came to Lut and gave him this warning the night before the disaster. They said, "Lut, We are messengers from your Lord. They will not be able to get at you. Set out with your family, except for your wife, in the middle of the night, and none of you should look back. What strikes them will strike her as well. Their promised appointment is the morning. Is the morning not close at hand? When our command came, we turned their cities upside down and rained down on them stones of hard-baked clay, piled on top of one another in layers, each one earmarked by your Lord, and they are never far from the wrongdoers. The expression, turning their cities upside down, in all probability refers to the region being shattered in a powerful earthquake. According to a news story carried by the BBC under the title, Scientists Uncover Sodom's Fiery End, the British geologist Graham Harris was one of the scientists to discover powerful evidence on the subject. According to Dr. Harris, Sodom had been built on the shores of the Dead Sea and traded in the asphalt found in the region. This tarry substance was used in ancient times to waterproof boats and to hold stones together in buildings. Yet this settlement area, right by the Dead Sea, also stood on very unstable land. This was the point where two tectonic plates moving in opposite directions met. This was an earthquake zone. The layers of lava and basalt unearthed during the excavations are the strongest proof that there had been a volcanic eruption and earthquake here. The event described in the Quran in the words, "rained down on them stones of hard-baked clay," was in all probability a volcanic eruption. The event described in the same verse in the words, "When our command came, we turned their cities upside down," may well refer to the ruptures and destruction caused by the earthquake. Under the Dead Sea shores lie large deposits of flammable methane pockets. The earthquake would have set these in motion and ignited them. The ground would have turned into a quicksand, and a massive landslide would have swept the city into the water. A series of scientific experiments at Cambridge University confirmed this theory. Scientists built a replica of the region in which the people of Lut had settled in the laboratory and induced an artificial earthquake. As had been expected, the earth was inundated and the miniature houses slid into it and were buried there. These archaeological and experimental discoveries reveal one important fact. The people of Lut discussed in the Quran really lived in the past and were punished for their perversions by a disaster sent by God. All the evidence for that disaster has today been revealed. and is in complete agreement with the account given in the Quran. Once again, the fact is revealed that the Quran is the word of God. So the great blast seized hold of them at the break of day. We turned the place completely upside down and rained down on them stones of hard-baked clay. There are certainly signs in that for the discerning.